No, there's no injury news. No, nothing's changed from previous game. We've got the same group, no problems from the two matches, so it's good for us. Same Solly March trained the first part of the session today, so that's good. He's progressing as we thought, but the Chelsea game will be too soon for him, and Jose the same position.
So how do you confront this Chelsea game as a challenger, because you've seen them win Arsenal and at Tottenham in the last 8-9 days away from home, but they've also lost to 3 of the bottom 6 in the last month as well. I mean, how does that sort of play on your mind? Because, you know, you're almost wondering if Chelsea's going to turn up in a way, aren't you?
Well, I think they've away from home, they've been really good. At home, they've had a couple of problems. It just shows the Premier League how competitive and how tight it is. And from our perspective, we can't really focus too much on that. We have to get our own performance in order and make sure we're good ourselves at home, and you know, on the back of a good victory, we need to try and play well, and then understand that Chelsea are going to come with a good team, and they're going to look to try and win the game, because they're a top team that's competing in the top end of the Premier League and in the Champions League, so we know it's a tough match for us.
Looking at your record against the top six of the team, beating Spurs and Arsenal, where you played very well, as well as anyone has at Anfield recently as well, have you ever seen a mentality change to some degree, do you think, because the record against the top six in the previous two seasons wasn't particularly good?
I don't know. I can't comment on any change, because obviously I wasn't here before. We try to go into every game with a belief and a mentality that it's possible to win. And at the same time, you know, in any game of football, you can lose. So we got that as our starting point. And then you have to try and implement what you want to do in the game. Understand, though, that the opposition are trying the same. And, it's about doing your best and seeing what happens. But clearly the top six are a different level. That's historically the fact. But I don't think it should go onto a football pitch thinking you've got no chance as well.
You're up against some of those players, Tomori, Mount, Abraham in the Championship last season. Are you surprised at how well they've acquitted themselves in the Premier League this season and also made a mark with England?
No. I really like them. When we were at Swansea, played against them a couple of times, liked them as players. I think credit must go to Frank as well for understanding them, of course, and then integrating them into his group, and again into a team that has the responsibility of trying to be in the top four in the Premier League, and also trying to progress in the Champions League. So it isn't easy, and they've done a great job there. So, but no, you can see the qualities they had. Of course, the Championship is a different level of competition, but their attributes, you could see that they could use them in the Premier League as well.
You spoke about VAR after the Bournemouth game. There seems to be a growing list of people queuing up to criticise it. Now, would you say your position on the technology has changed now compared to at the start of the season? And also, do you think that possibly it's the offside thing that's causing a lot of the issues, and maybe that just needs a bit of clarification?
I don't think my position's completely changed at all. I think we're talking about the offside because that's the most recent thing. When it was the clear obvious, it was the clear obvious. If you go back to, I don't know, 2 years ago, before VAR, we were probably talking about a referee's decision or a linesman's decision and saying we need the technology. It's the 21st century, why are we not using it? I just think it's football culture, football mentality in a way. I want to sort of support it because it's here, but I think we're looking at the problem in the wrong way, is my opinion.
You would say looking at the problem in the wrong way. What do you mean? You think it's too early to do away with it?
Yeah, I think we bring it in because we want correct decisions, and we want everything to be consistent, and we want everything to be right. But I think football's a game of mistakes. It's played by human beings, and they're going to get them wrong. And if you accept that, then I'm not so sure there's a real need for technology. But in the culture of wanting to blame somebody, because before it was about blaming the referee or a linesman for losing, and now we're blaming VAR. It's the same. They're going to get things wrong. There are going to be things that you're not going to like as soon as you bring in an objective measure of offside or not. Now, all of a sudden, if you're a millimetre off, you're offside. But everybody knows in football that it's a goal, really. You know, including the goal that Harry Kane scores against us for Tottenham in football, in terms of the guys in the ground, the supporters, it's a goal. And football has got to this point with that being a goal, and now because of VAR and because it's literally offside by a millimetre, that it's offside, and so that does change a lot. But again, whilst we've got that mentality, that's how it is. The only thing the next thing we're going to do is probably get rid of the referees, get rid of the linesmen, because we want everything so correct. I don't understand why we want that. But if we want everything so correct, then in the end, just do away with linesmen, referees, put drones up, use computers, artificial intelligence, and I'm sure we'll get all the decisions correct. But I don't think anybody will really like football anymore. I think football at times is really unfair, but that's what's so good about it. It's like life. Sometimes you get on the wrong end of a decision and you have to get on with it. And I think if we take that away from the game, then we are changing the game.
Move on and ask about Aaron Moy. Very impressive in recent games. Good loan signing for you. Are you concerned though that if you don't get a deal tied down for him sooner rather than later, with his improved performances, he could attract attention of maybe big fish in this division?
No, I'm not really concerned about it. I've not really thought about it in those terms. As I said before, he's a loan player. He's not our player. So just feels player, but. We understand we've got him for the full season. There's no stress, there's no pressure. The most important thing is that Aaron is enjoying his football and we're happy with him, and he's improving and developing. That's the most important thing, and everything else is just talk and speculation.
What was your impression of what happened at West Ham? They've obviously moved a manager out, brought one in. Does it have any implications for the teams around you in that area of the table? David Moyes coming in, experience, got them out of trouble. West Ham a couple of years ago. Can it change the dynamics down there?
I'm not sure. I've not thought about it. Again, it's a shame when somebody loses their job. Don't like to see that. Obviously wish David well in his new job. It's part of the football, part of life. Who knows?
You've played well enough in recent games to have won more than you have done. So how much was it of a relief to get over the line against Bournemouth and convert that dominance into 3 points?
Yeah, it was a relief, not going to lie, because we're in the business to get points, and when you don't get points, doesn't matter what you do, you know, you're wrong. You're doing something wrong and you need to change, you need to do something else, and that's just the life we're in. I didn't think we were so good against Bournemouth. We probably played better and not got anything, but we did enough to win. I think we deserve to win. But we're at the stage where I think points and results are, of course, they're always important. At the same time, there's no, as I said before, I don't think you can guarantee a style or a way that guarantees Brighton wins in the Premier League. I don't think it's, and if there is, then please tell me that, because it'd make my job a lot easier. All we can do is try to work towards a certain way, a performance, and then hopefully that can get us results. But it's nice to get a win.
Is it a concern at all that you've played really well, but you haven't been able to, like I say, convert some of those dominant performances into victories, especially when it comes to taking chances?
I don't think it's a concern. Well, the concern in so much as you don't get the points, and that's, you know, that is what it is. But it's, I wouldn't say concern. It's part of the process, part of what we have to do to improve. In an ideal world, I'd love to sit here every week after winning, but the reality of that in the Premier League, unless you're Liverpool, is really difficult. So why waste energy? I know people from the outside put pressure and say you should do this, you should do that, and no, that's fine. But my job is to just see the situation for what it is and try and improve and try and help the players get better. And that's all we've been doing.
What do you make of what Frank's done tactically so far this season? Because obviously the first game was a lot earlier on in the campaign. What do you make of him so far?
No, I think he's done a really good job. Really good job. I like him. I like him a lot. I was impressed at Derby. and I'm impressed again at Chelsea. I think to manage the situation that he's inherited in terms of the embargo that they've had, to deal with that in a positive way that they've done with young players. And been flexible in his approach in terms of how to play, and then to compete at the top end of the Premier League, top four, and also to go through the Champions League, he's done really well.
You mentioned flexibility. He's not afraid to make changes early on in games, is he? Which shows a degree of bravery and confidence.
No, he knows the game, and he's an intelligent guy. So that combination, I suppose, is just then you just got to do what you think is the right thing to do. But yeah, like I said, I've been impressed.
You played the established top six away from home, all of them now. What did you learn from the Chelsea game? Because we've talked a lot about the performances away from home against the strong sides. What did you and the team learn from that particular game, do you think?
That if we play like that, we don't win anywhere, pretty much, was the feeling afterwards. We weren't good. Of course, Chelsea were worthy of the win and deserved to win, but from us we were in a bit of a tricky moment. I think we had a few problems injury and illness wise at that time, and that probably affected us a little bit too much. But it was a stark reminder that if you don't perform to the level that you need to perform, then it's very, very difficult anywhere away from home in the Premier League, especially the top teams.
January transfer window opens on Wednesday. I know you've mentioned it a few times, but is there a particular area of the pitch that you'd maybe think about strengthening in particular if something came along? I mean, I know you said you're happy with the squad. Is there some area of the pitch that you feel could do the strengthening?
No, I've said before, I think we, as a collective, we can improve in all of the areas. We need to do that, but I'd rather focus on the guys that we've got here and help them improve, because I don't think that they're, like I said, at the maximum. It's not like I'm sitting here thinking we've got the most out of this group of players. And so then there's no desperate need to do anything from my perspective. I really enjoy working with the players. I enjoy what we're trying to do. As I've indicated before, we're not perfect, and there's no guarantees in terms of results, but I'm happy with their daily approach and work, and I'm happy for that to continue. But again, I've also said that the responsibility of a football club in every window is to try to see if there's a way you can strengthen. Mm-hmm. But there's no news on that.
Any news on New Year's resolutions for you then? Is 2020 the new decade?
No, I've got nothing, to be honest. I'm too weak.
Still, Karen's